The number 7 Chargers are here to get a win over their nearby rival and look to junior Izzy DiNapoli to lead them on the mound and in the batter's box. Number 3 Columbine, they want to improve on their stellar 20-2 record and are led by today's junior starter, the D1 prospect Corby Otis. Nice weather here in West Littleton before an expected winter storm. Let's go to the opening frame. No score. Courtney Bidwell fans as Otis is off to a great start, striking out the side. To the home half of the first, and there's DiNapoli in the circle getting the start, and she gets Emma Todd to ground off the plate to first, and the Rebels go 1-2-3 as well to end the inning as pitching dominates early. And look who's in attendance during a break in practice. It's the number 1 Columbine football squad supporting the softball athletes. Nice work. We fast forward to the fourth as Columbine has a runner in scoring position for Savannah Waldrop, who singles up the middle, scoring Riley Marshall, and the Rebels break through for the 1-0 lead. To the fifth, now 3-0 Rebels, and Allie Dissler pops the ball to left center. Alana Barkley scores, adding to the Rebel lead. And then the front roared in, kicking up dust with gusts up to 50 miles an hour. Needless to say, conditions then deteriorated, but the teams would play on. Now 7-0 Rebels as Otis helps her own cause with a drive to the wall. Waldrop scores and it's 8-0. To the 6th, 9-0 Columbine for Riley Marshall, who sends the shot over the drawn-in infield. The winning run scores, that second run not necessary, and the Rebels get the emphatic 10-0 victory over the rival Chatfield in 6 innings.
It's our biggest rival, and I have a lot of teammates from like club team on that team, so it felt nice.
We're preparing to win it all, and I think as long as we stick with what we're doing, stick with our approach, keep doing our jobs, I think we can go as far as we want.